Okay, so in the previous video we designed this image uploading thing. Now let's add some JavaScript stuffs. Okay, so this is the first time I think we have to use JavaScript in our framework. Okay, so I hope you have some sort of experience in JavaScript, because otherwise if I'm going to detail in much more detail, somewhat long this episode. It will make somewhat long this episode. But if you don't know these JavaScript stuffs, I think you can go for some internet resources. There are more than enough resources for JavaScript, and please check those out as well. So image upload. And I will make it as image upload dot js. Okay, so first I will write the JavaScript statement, then I will show you how to import this to our view. So first I will write functions related to profile, image, drag and drop. So const drop area document get, or maybe I can use the query selector. The query selector is somewhat take the class out of the HTML elements. Then drop text, description, then form browse button, from upload or something like that. So this is browse button. You have to have input path. So in my case I will use the ID. Sorry. Then I need a variable to store my file. Then let's set browse options and upload options. So whenever I click the browse button on click, input path dot click, right? So let's try whether this is working or not. Yeah, it's not working because I haven't imported. So you can simply go to the HTML file, and before loading the footer, maybe you can call this script. I will add JavaScript for profile image. So script type is text JavaScript. The source is again somewhat similar. URL root. Go to the JS components, image upload, image upload to JS, and simply close the script. Now go here, refresh it. Okay, Let's go to the inspect. Yeah. Components image upload to JS. Okay, image has been uploaded, but form upload. Let me alert something. Okay, so our JavaScript file has imported correctly. Maybe I think these are the things, but somehow our import path is not clicking. So maybe we can add event listener as well instead of just using this on click. But yes, it needs to be working. Form upload is there. Okay, so let me alert over here. Yeah, that's the case. This event is not triggering because I have used capital C. Yeah, now it's working. Good. So I can remove this. JavaScript is somewhat, you know, tricky thing. If you miss even test cases, it won't give the results. Yeah, let's add the event listener for our input path. Add event listener. So whenever you change this, which means you have selected the image, then we will invoke this function. So this function will basically set the file as your very first selected file, because you don't need to take multiple files. Then I can call some function called image show image, but I will implement this function in later. Now I need to add drag and drop stuffs as well. So at event listener, so whenever you drag over any sort of a file, you have to invoke an event or maybe call a function, which is event prevent default, because you don't need to go for any email page. All we need to add a class list for a specific division, so we can you know, somewhat manipulate our HTML elements when we are drag and dropping files. And drop text can be also changed as release the, let's say release to upload the file, and drop area dot add event listener. So whenever you drag leave again, it will trigger an event, but you don't need to take any events. It will simply add a class list, which is again not the add, but will remove. Active class list will be removed, and the drop text text content will be same as before, which is this one. Okay, then finally, not the final, yeah, the next event is when you are dropping it. Yeah, so this is a crucial function. We need to set few more variables because now we have dropped our file. So basically event.event default, then we have to take the file from the event using data transferring. So data transfer. So these are just properties in, you know, JavaScript objects. Data transfer properties from the first file. So let's make a list. New data transfer. So list dot items dot add, let's set the file. Then let's set our input path files as the list dot files. Then we can call the function show image, and we can make our drop area class list dot remove the active class. And finally, we can show the image. Okay, so make sure you add the semicolons after each functions. Right. Then final thing is show image. Right. So this can be easily done. So first I will check the corresponding file types, whether these are associated file types or not. So file dot type, I will make the valid extensions because I need to only select image files. So basically those are image jpeg are acceptable, image jpg are acceptable, and image maybe png are acceptable. So if you want, you can take GIF files as well. Graphical interchange format images. So I will include the file types. So it will basically check whether our file is something belongs to this valid extensions. So if it is valid, then it will return a true. So we can simply make a file reader, which is new file reader. Then file reader dot onload, we can invoke an event which is setting our file URL. So file reader dot result, then document dot query selector. So this profile image placeholder thing we need to take, but remember it's an ID. Then we can set the attribute of SRCS, file URL. So then we can read as URL. Data URL associated with the file, and we can validate it to show our validate thing is correct, which means we can increase our opacity. So query selector, so that is this one, file image validation. So validate dot class list dot add the active class. So if not, simply we can alert user whether you have selected the wrong type of file or something like that. So this is not an image file. Then we can simply remove the active class. Right, now go to the browser, reload it. So whenever I click it, I can simply select a file, but it's still not changing because I need to call on change over my input button. So inside the input button, input file button, can call on change. I don't think that will be necessary. Let's try drag and drop maybe. Okay, drag and drop is working. So our image is set, right? So you can drag and drop any other file. See, when you are dragging, it will show you the theme. But again, the text is not setting, right? But the images and those stuffs are working. Why is that? Description. The drop text also need to be changed. Yeah. Yes. Did I add my text content correctly? Chance, okay. Yeah, so this is setting an attribute. So it will look like this. So now reload it, go to images. Yeah, now it will, I know, say release to upload the file. Okay, so whenever I click the browse button, that show image function is not calling, I guess. Why is that? It needs to be called because, yeah. So first let's try to alert this, whether this button is working or not. Yeah, that function is not called because input path. Profile image. Yeah, this is these files. Now let's try that. Yeah, now it's setting and calling. So I missed the S data over here, just type it as files. So now we can both select a specific image, or else we can simply drag and drop an image. Okay, both work. And whenever required, we can change the images as well. Okay, I think as the client side programming, JavaScript stuff, something like that. And in the next video, I will show you how to add PHP related functions over these stuff. And yeah, thank you.